Hello world! In this video, I'm gonna show you how to connect VP.NET to MySQL database using MySQL Connector. First step is to download and install the connector, which can be downloaded here. Click download button. They'll ask for login. If you don't have any user ID yet, just register first. After login, there is a form to fill. Fill it and we'll get the download link after. Done downloading, let's double click to install. Click run and next. Choose typical and click install. While done, click finish. Open the Visual Studio. I'm using 2019 Community Edition. Create a new project. We'll make a Visual Basic Windows Forms. Its template is existing in the recent. But if not, you can find it by choosing drop-down, Visual Basic Language, Windows, and Desktop. Choose Form Application, then click Next. Name the project, for example, VP.NET MySQL. We can also pick file store location, solution name, and .NET framework to be used. Click Create. Okay. Here it is, my project solution. Go to Solution Explorer for reference node, right click, add reference. Browse to the installation folder to find the reference we need. In my PC, it was in program files x86 MySQL. We installed version of 8.0.23, so pick this one. Find mysql.data.dll, pick and click add button. It will display reference manager, then click OK. In this form, I'll add a button that will be used for checking connection. Change its text into check connection. Rename it to BTN connection. Adjust the size of button and double click to open code window. We need to add import mysql.data.mysql client. Then declare variable name con as mysql connection. Under button click events, set con as a new object connection. Then give a connection string. Type server name. I'm using localhost. Then user ID, still use the default root and fill the password that been set in MySQL. But mine here just blank, so let it just like this. Finally, my database name is Latihan. Please use your own setting. We'll open a connection, but before, we need to add an error handling by adding try catch. Then type con.open here. Below, give a message box to show that connection has been successfully connected. That's it, and we close again the connection. Cause here I just wanna show you how it can be connected. For the exception, we also give a message that displays text from exception message. And finally, we add finally. The code under this will always be executed whether success or fail. Put condispose here. Let's try to run the bug. Click check connection button and ta-da! We did it! Okay guys, that's it for now. Next video will be about how to show data on grid view. I hope you learned something. Happy coding and bye!